Stanford Cardinal. BC opened the season with a win last week, thanks in part to this guy, William Green. He rushed for 204 yards against West Virginia. Now, he's ready to wreak havoc against the Cardinal. But Stanford also has an appetite for destruction. Head coach Tyrone Willingham leads a team heavy with seniors. With Randy Fasati calling signals and the team's leading rusher, Kerry Carter, running through defenses, these guys might be bowling this year. Turn the channel. Are you out of your tree? Boston College battles Stanford next on Fox Sports Net.
To Stanford Stadium here on the Stanford campus in Palo Alto, California. It's Pac-10 football as the Boston College Eagles make a house call for the first time on the Stanford Cardinal in a home-and-home series that begins tonight. And hello again, everybody. I'm Barry Tompkins, along with Warren Moon, my partner this year. Warren, of course, 23 seasons as a professional football quarterback, threw for 50,000 yards. Not too bad. Let's talk a little bit about this game, Warren. Of course, Boston College comes in here not only having played a game, but having won a game, and that's a real scare card for Stanford.
It really is, because they've gone through the pregame jitters. They've seen themselves on film after one game. They know what the adjustments are they have to make. It's a big advantage. Ty Willingham, on the other hand, he doesn't know exactly what he has. He hopes he has a good football team. He has a lot of anticipation, but until he actually gets out there and plays his football game, he's really not sure.
One thing that Ty does know, though, and that's that Boston College has a heck of a running back. Right now, he's leading the nation. William Green's the guy who's making a little noise here.
He really is, and I'm very impressed with him. The guy, like you said, had 204 yards last week, leads the nation in rushing. He's got everything you want in a running back. He's got great size, great vision. He can see the field, and he's got that thing I really like best. He's got that gleam in his eye that says, hey, I'm the best.
Now, what Stanford does have, though, and the Eagles truly don't have this, they're a very young team. Stanford has senior leadership, and what better position to have it at than the quarterback position?
That's where you want to have it, and Randy Fasani is their senior leader, and he's a fifth-year quarterback who needs to be on the field. He was hurt some last year, but when he was on the field, he was 5-3 as a starter. He's going to have to carry this team early in the year because he's got some young receivers, but in order for Stanford to be good this year, Randy Fasani has got to make plays.
Yeah, so what we really have here is the known and the unknown. And the known, of course, is William Green. This is a guy who really got it done last week against West Virginia. Stanford, Ty Willingham feels that he's really got a good thing, but he said, how good? I'll tell you on Sunday. We'll be back right after this. Welcome back. We are at Stanford Stadium, just about to get started between the Boston College Eagles and the Stanford Cardinal. Here come the Cardinal onto the field right now. Home opener, season opener for Stanford. As we said, Boston College has already played a game, and a winning game it was against West Virginia. Great confidence builder for this young football team of Tom O'Brien's. Barry Tompkins, along with Warren Moon, and right now let's take it to the field, meet the third member of our broadcast team, Jim Watson. Jimmy?
All right, Barry, thank you very much. You and Warren were talking about the offensive stars to keep an eye on, but there's a couple of guys defensively that you should keep an eye on as well. What about Sean Guthrie for Boston College, a 6'4 senior? This guy has already played 30 games, but he's going to bring some much-needed experience to a young Eagle unit. He's already graduated, and I talked about his undergrad classes. He said his favorite, Crime and Punishment. What about on the other side of the ball for the Stanford Cardinal? There's not a better story than Coy Wire. 2 years ago, he led the Cardinal in rushing as a running back, but last year, seeing his time would be limited, he went to the coaches and said, I want to get on the field, I want to play defense. They found a spot for him at linebacker. All he did was lead the Cardinal in tackles. We asked him what he missed most about his home in Pennsylvania. He said, raw meat. And you know what? It's dinner time. Boston College and Stanford coming up from the farm on Fox.
We welcome you back to Stanford Stadium, Boston College and Stanford. And Stanford won the toss and elected to receive. They will take the ball first. And I thought it was interesting in our conversation with Ty Willingham yesterday, Warren. He said, we need big plays. We got to make big plays. I have no doubt that's why they're taking the ball.
There's no question you want the ball first. You want to get your hands on it. You want to knock people in the face as quickly as you possibly can. And he said it early in the game that you got to get off to a good start. The early part of this ball game is going to be very important for the Stanford Cardinal.
Ken Dudnick will kick it away. He'll be kicking to Ryan Wells and Brian Allen. That is Wells at the left-hand side of your screen, Allen at the right. Both can scoot. Early part of this game, both coaches agree, is going to be very important. We're underway. Short kick. Wells at the four. To the 20, still on his feet, steps outside, still on his feet at the 25, gets close to the 30-yard line. Good return. Let's take a look at our lineups. First of all, offensively, brought to you by Kyocera. Randy Fasani will be the quarterback. Those were his numbers from last year. He's banged up much of last year, remember. Offensive line, very experienced, and the strength of this Stanford team, according to all the coaching staff. Brian Allen with Casey Moore will start. We'll see plenty of Kerry Carter, Luke Powell, Ryan Wells, and Brett Pierce will be the tight end. Powell is the big play guy. He is in the slot. Caleb Bowman in the ball game also. So three wideouts on the first snap. And they give a play fake. And Fasani going for the bundle here. Throws for Wells, and it's almost intercepted. Wells, for some reason, held up on his route. Ralph Parent was there to defend. Well, defensively for Boston College, Guthrie is the guy that Jimmy Watson spoke about. He's the experience there with Goodwin, Martin, and Garay. Garay experienced on the outside, on the other side as well. The linebackers, Bradley, Churchu, and Williams. And the secondary, Lenny Walls brings experience and size, but everywhere else there's a lot of inexperience, and Stanford hopes to exploit that. They tried it on the first snap. It didn't work. Give this time to the fullback. That's Casey Moore. An integral part of this offense, incidentally. He gets two.
Casey Moore is a guy they want to get the ball in his hands in a lot more ways. Catching the football, actually running the football. I didn't expect him to run the ball very much today, but they're going to try and get the ball in his hands as many ways as they possibly can because he's a very talented running back.
You see those numbers that substantiate that. So it'll be third down for Stanford and eight. Teo Johnson in the game for the first time. And we'll talk a little more about him, but he gives you a matchup prop. Big size. He's in the slot to the right side. Fasani straight back. That's going to be a hold right in the middle of the line. I'm absolutely certain.
And this is one of the concerns of Coach Willingham. He doesn't know what his kicking game is going to be this year because Eric is new. You just never know until that first game is over with. And he said, we'll know by Sunday just how well our punting game is.
Exactly. I'm sure he was not pleased with the first offensive series. Threw it out. So Johnson's first punt is a collegiate. Gets it away. Line drive, twisting kick. Handled. And nowhere to go for DeWalt. So the Eagles will have it for the first time. Good coverage. 41-yard punt and no return. Here are the lineups for BC, brought to you by Kyocera. Brian St. Pierre, who will take over for Hasselback, that is Ken Hasselback. Mark Parenteau, John Richardson, Copen, Hoffman, and Colombo, their most experienced player, the right tackle. William Green, he's the real deal. And if the name Camello sounds familiar to Stanford fans, his brother Greg played here at Stanford. Dedrick DeWalt with Burke, very physical wide receiver. DeWalt can scoot, they have big play guys. Play fake, St. Pierre, quick hitch, caught this time by Burke, and Burke will have about eight. Ryan Fernandez stops it. Defensively for the Stanford Cardinal, Austin Reed with Matt Leonard, Trey Freeman, and Marcus Hoover. Gabriel, Friedrichs, and Wire are the linebackers, and if Gabriel goes down, Stanford says, we got a problem. Here's where the experience is for Stanford in the secondary. Carter, Hodari, Tank Williams, an All-American, and Fernandez. Second and two. This is Green for the first time. Trying to bounce outside, nothing doing. Wrapped up by Anthony Gabriel.
And this is what you have to do against Green. You're going to have to really play your run lanes because this guy can bounce it outside. And once he gets outside, he has great speed. Just a great job out there by Gabriel.
One of the things that always has been questioned insofar as Stanford is concerned is defensive quickness. And talking with the coaches yesterday, they seem to feel that this year they have that.
They really do it in a lot of different places, not just in the secondary, not just in the linebackers, but they have great speed up front, too. And that's something that Ty has been trying to develop ever since he's come here to Stanford. He thinks he has the type of talent that he needs now to be successful in this conference.
Third down and four. St. Pierre, short drop, slant for Burke, incomplete. Luke Powell's going to be the deep man for Stanford. You look at him right there, and again, he is the big play guy for the Cardinal, and somebody moved.
I believe it's going to go against the Eagles. Francois Brochu was a man of the long snap.
Illegal snap, offense. Penalty is 5 yards, down remains four.
Something you don't want to do is back yourself any more than you're already backed up. Field position is very key in a game like this, especially at the beginning.
They come after this one, they got it. They block it. And Stanford will have it at the 12-yard line. Coming through with the block was Coy Wire. Well, there's the big play we talked about.
There's no question that Coy Wire has been making big plays ever since he's come to this university. They must have saw something in the armor of Boston College because they came after it on the first punt. Here they come right up the middle, a little bitty twist, and Wire comes through and just lays his body out and gets on the football. Big play for Stanford to start off the season.